Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you NFV, Network Function Visualization. Let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll be discussing about basics of NFV. Then I'll explain you architecture of NFV. And at last, I'll explain you key components of NFV. Let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of NFV. See, NFV means Network Function Visualization. See, NFV, that is a concept of replacing dedicated network devices like router and firewalls with software running general purpose CPUs or virtual machines operating on standard server. So here, with the use of concept of NFV, we will be replacing physical devices like routers and firewalls with the use of softwares which we will be running on general purpose CPUs and virtual machines. I'll show you that in architecture as well as in components, so that will give you more clarity. Right now, just understand this. See, NFV, that is used to replace routers and firewalls which are existing in network. And that is what we are replacing by softwares that we will be executing on general purpose CPUs and on virtual machines. See, NFV provides infrastructure on which SDN can run. SDN means software defined networking. I have made separate video on it. See, NFV is providing infrastructure on which SDN can run, right? See, NFV and SDN are mutually beneficial to each other, but both are not depending on each other. So here there is a mutual benefits of NFV and SDN, right? But they are independent, right? Now let me show you basic architecture of NFV. So in architecture of NFV, there are three key components. First is network function visualization infrastructure, that is NFVI. See, NFVI, that is having three layers. First layer is hardware resources layer, in which there will be physical CPUs, there will be physical memory, and there will be physical network. Second layer is virtualization layer. That virtualization layer that provides supports where it will be translating physical resources into virtual one. And third layer is having virtual resources like virtual CPUs, virtual memory, and virtual network. I'll explain you this in great detail in component section. Right now consider first component is NFVI, that is NFV infrastructure. Second component is virtualized network function, VNF. See, this VNFs, that is providing virtualization to the infrastructure which is there in NFV. So in short, you can say VNF is providing support to NFVI. That also I'll explain you in great detail in component section. And third component of architecture is NFV management and orchestration. So here, entire management and organization that is been done with NFV. Now I'll explain you these three components in great details. So when you talk about key components of NFV, then first is NFVI, that is network function visualization infrastructure. There are three layers which already I have shown you in architecture. See, first layer is having hardware resources like CPU, storage resources like hard disk, and network resources like router, switch, and firewalls. So here we are having physical resources, right? Like CPU, memory, network resources like router, switch, firewalls. So these are the physical resources that is there in first layer of NFVI. Second layer is having virtualization layer, which will be separating hardware and it will be replacing it with software. So second layer will be providing replacement of hardware to software, means it will be doing virtualization of hardware resources, right? And third layer of NFVI, that is virtualized resources like virtual computers, virtual network, and virtual storage. In short, in NFVI, we are having three layers. First layer is having hardware. Second layer provides virtualization, and third layer is having virtual resources. In hardware, we will be having physical resources like CPU, memory storage, routers, switches, firewalls. Second layer provides virtualization of hardware to software. And in third layer, we are having virtual resources, right? Those virtual resources can be shared for any particular task, right? And that can be supported with SDN network as well. So in third layer, we are having virtual resources like virtual CPU, virtual network, virtual storage, right? Second key component of NFV, that is virtualized network function. See here, this VNF, virtualized network function, that gives support to NFVI. So VNF is a software implementation of network function, and VNF is capable of running over NFVI, means VNF, that is working over NFVI. It provides software resources to implement network function, right? For example, virtual firewall, virtual router. See, these are the virtual resources that we want to implement. So VNF, that provides software implementation over NFVI, for example, virtual firewall, virtual router, virtual storage, that is our virtual resources that we are creating, right? So that has been created with the use of software implementation in VNF. And third key component is NFV management and orchestration. So here, see, with NFV management and orchestration, there are three components. First is virtualized infrastructure manager. See, this virtualized infrastructure manager is controlling and managing network function with NFVI resources and monitors the virtualization layer. So it is doing controlling and management task of NFVI, right? So here we are having hardware resources and virtualized resources with NFVI. So controlling and management of these resources, that is been done by virtual infrastructure manager, right? As well as it will be monitoring virtualization layer. So here, see, virtualization layer, that is a second layer of NFVI. So that is also monitored by virtualized infrastructure manager, which is a part of NFV management and orchestration. Second part of NFV management and orchestration is VNF manager. See, it is managing life cycle of VNF. So it will define for how much time resources could be shared, right? So it manages the life cycle of VNF, such as initialization, updation, query, scale, and termination. So here, how exactly resources will be shared, that timings are defined by VNF manager, right? And third component of VNFV management and orchestration is orchestration. Orchestrator means what? It manages the life cycle of network services. So here we are talking about how hardware is getting utilized in manager, right? But in orchestrator, it is providing life cycle network services, which includes policy, management, performance, measurement, and monitoring. So here management is done at orchestrator side. Here VNF manager is managing life cycle with virtual resources, right? And that virtualization function implementation, that we do it at second component. And this virtualized infrastructure manager, that is controlling and managing NFVI, that one can say in short. The reason is, with NFVI, we are having hardware resources and virtualized resources. Both are getting managed by virtualized infrastructure manager. And this virtualized layer, that is been monitored by virtualized infrastructure manager. So that is how all three key components are there with NFV. I hope you have understood this session. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.